lesson tells us that there is more than enough.
Oh, right.
Look at your neighbor, tell them more than enough.
More than enough.
But it has to be tapped.
Yeah. Look out. Yeah.
Let me let that settle into your spirit like the Holy Spirit let it settle into mine. There is more than enough. But it has to be tapped.
Cruel irony.
Why am I dry with so much water? Why is this water out of reach? And I said, you know, Jesus said, if you knew who I am, you would ask me for water. And it begs the question, have we asked the source? Who are we asking to give us water? Who is it that we're going to? You know, are we asking the source of water for water? Or are we asking other dry people? It's not a question, Pastor Tony, of what have you done for me lately, but what can you do for me? You dry, I'm dry. Maybe we just need to ask the source of living water to give us water. Somebody got water. But it may not be the ones who we have been asking for water. I'm almost through here. You need to tell your neighbor, there is greatness in you. Because God is in you. You don't have to look for external sources to find help. You don't have to go to MegaFest to get it. I'm sorry, Bishop. You don't have to go to MegaFest to get it. You can get it in this room, right here, right now. You can get it driving down the street in your car. You can get it on BART because the well is in you. I'm almost through. Yeah. Stop looking for everybody else's water. What about the water that is in you? You were born with it. You were born in it and you were born filled with it. Listen to me. Listen to me. You were born in it, but you were born with it in you. There is water in you. Tell your neighbor, look for your well. But look inside. And it begs another question. Why would you die when there's a well of water in you? Why would you die? Why? Why would you die when there's a well of water inside of you? Let me ask it another way. Where is the purpose and the glory and the joy and the plan of God for me? If you're really, really tired of feeling sorry for yourself and being depressed and having a sad story all the time, a sad story to tell, you got to look for your own water. Don't even ask your partner, your friend, your son, your daughter to reveal it to you. You've got to go in you and find your juice. Find your water. There is a well. Don't tell me you don't have one, because I know greater is God that is in us than God that is in this world. Listen to me carefully. You got all that God is already living in you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Well, I'm waiting for the Lord to do something. All that God's gonna do. Everything God is going to provide. Every way that God is going to make. Every healing that God is going to do is already in you. The question is, how do you tap it and make it a part of your right now? Let me get down here. Let me offer you this. This would be point two. Hidden water can sustain life, but just barely. That's what the golden catfish would tell you. Hidden water can sustain life, but just barely. Because life cannot thrive in the dark. Hidden water can sustain life, but just barely. Because life cannot survive in the dark. It cannot thrive in the dark. It is not made for the dark. If you keep a living thing too long in the dark, it does not receive what it needs from the sun. Listen to me. From the S-U-N or from the S-O-N. So it begs the question, what is it then, Bishop? That's the problem. I said, you know, what I realize and what my life has taught me is that your gifts must come to the light. Say that to your neighbor. Your gifts must come to the light. Tell them it's time, it's time. Keep telling them it's time, it's time, it's time. It's time, it's time, it's time, it's time. It's time. Your gifts must come to the light. Essentially, your gifts are of little use if you don't share them. Your gifts are of little use tucked away in a cave. Listen to me. The golden catfish is alive, but it's alone. I said it's alive, but it's blind. And it eats garbage. Let me do that again. The goldfish is alive, but it's alone. It's alive, but it's blind. And it eats garbage. Do you hear me, what I'm saying to you? We're worth more than that. Tell your neighbor you're worth more than that. You're worth more than that. Time to come out of that hole, out of that cave. Time to come out of the dark and into the light. What is it that keeps us reticent? Many things keep our gifts in the dark. Fear?
Yes.
Doubt?
Yes.
Negative influences?
Yes.
Past failure?
Yes.
Sadness? Anger?
Yes.
That's what people and circumstances do to your water.
Yes, they do.
Right. Oh, I know what I'm talking about. That's what people and circumstances do to your water. Can I share something with you? In the book of John, the 7th chapter, you don't have to go, but read it when you get home. John 7. And I just want to read a verse or two to you, if that's okay. John 7 starts at verse 37. It says, Jesus said, and if anyone thirsts, let him or her come to me and drink. That's what Jesus said. And if they do it out of their bellies, will flow rivers. Is that what your grandma said? Of living water. And they will be filled to the brim, and it will spill out of the depths of anyone who believes in me, Jesus said. And when he said this, he was talking about the Spirit. Say, the Spirit is your water. Let me get done. And the people in the crowd heard what he said. Somebody said he has to be a prophet. Somebody said he's the Messiah. And others said, but wait a minute, the Messiah doesn't come from Galilee. This is what people do to your water. They said that the Messiah doesn't come from Galilee, does he? Oh, the Messiah can't be a you. A person with that kind of gift can't be like you. A person with that kind of gift can't look like you. A person with that kind of gift can't live with AIDS. A person with that kind of gift can't be a woman. A person with that kind of gift can't be young. A person with that kind of gift can't be old. A person with that kind of gift can't be gay. That's what people do to your water. That's what they do to your water. Said he can't come from Galilee. Doesn't the scripture say that the Messiah will come from David's line? From Bethlehem? Then there was a split in the crowd, and some went as far as wanting to arrest Jesus, but nobody laid a hand on him. Then the temple police reported back to the high priest and said, and said, you should hear what he's saying. And the high priest said, you should have arrested him and brought him to us. And then the temple police said, but you don't understand. You don't hear how he talks. We've never heard anybody talk like this. We heard him and we felt his water. I'm almost through. And the Pharisees say, what's wrong with you? Are you being carried away like the rest of the rabble? Don't you see that none of the leaders believe in him? None of the big hats and handkerchiefs believe in him. None of the big Bibles and big Cadillacs believe in him. None of the big bishops believe in him. So why would you believe in him? Have you seen any of the Pharisees who believe in him? Only these crowds, these ignorant ones, have taken him seriously. That's what the high church leaders, but one of the Pharisees named Nicodemus. Y'all know Nicodemus. You know some about his story. Because he became a believer. Well, he was almost a believer in this passage. Nicodemus rolled up and he said, now wait a minute. Doesn't our law decide a man's guilt? Or does our law decide a man's guilt without first listening to him and finding out for ourselves what he's doing?
That's right.
Tell your neighbor, find out for yourself. I want you to hear what I'm saying. I don't care what church has taught you. Tell everybody you heard me say it. I don't care what Mother Full Bosom and Bishop Big Bottom taught you. I don't care what church has taught you. Find God for yourself. Find water for yourself. And then the Pharisees cut him off while he was talking. They said, shut up, Nicodemus. Are you out here campaigning for this Galilean? Are you out here campaigning for this low-life, loose-living person out here? Are you campaigning? Don't you know he consorts with lepers,
right.
Prostitutes.
Right.
He consorts with nasty, dirty people
right.
all the time. Are you
yeah.
out here campaigning for him?
Yeah.
Then they said to him, it's only this crowd that's ignorant of the law that believes in him.
Yeah.
And they said, watch and see, no prophet can come from Galilee. That's what they told me. I said, that's what they told me. No prophet can be not like you. No prophet can believe what you believe. No prophet can be who you are. No prophet can say what you say. You know the rest of the story. What am I saying to you, beloved? That's what people do to your water.
Right.
What you got to be able to do is claim your own water.
Right.
Oh, and bring it up out of the dark. Oh, hear me. Time for you to bring your own water up out of the dark. Bring it up. And whatever it is that has repressed your gifts and made you feel that somehow all of the who you are is not all of what God wants. Come on, hear me now. God knows all about you. God made you. And God, the God that made you, he made you to be the who you are right now in this place. And the God that made you is the God that will hone your gifts. I know what I'm talking about. And make them useful for God's purpose. What shall we say to these things? What shall we say to these things? I want you to get your mind on your negative list and all your excuses for hiding your gifts. All of the reasons why you think you won't be accepted, appreciated, and affirmed. What shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us?